be a stiff. Join me, Dr. Paul Bearer, for a horrible old movie Saturday at noon, right here on your 44.
Channel 44 presents Creature Feature.
Good afternoon, and welcome to Channel 44's Creature Feature. And now, your host, Dr. Paul Bearer.
Good afternoon, Fright fans. I'm Ed Tucker, an author and film historian, and I'm coming to you dead from the set of the Tenement Castle. I was one of those lucky 1970s monster kids that grew up getting to watch Dr. Paul Bearer and the 44 Creature Feature every Saturday afternoon from the time it premiered in September of 1973 until the final broadcast in February of 1995. In 1991, I was fortunate enough to be part of a group that produced a movie marathon tribute to Creature Feature. And as part of that, I got to spend an incredible afternoon interviewing Dick Benick and find out everything about the background of the show. So for the first time anywhere, I'd like to share a clip of that interview with you and let Dick Benick explain to you in his own words how his famous alter ego got created.
And I had, at this point, in fact, I still have every issue of Famous Monsters of Filmland that had ever been printed. And this was at a point where they had about 6 years of it, you see, or 5 or 6 years. So I went through all these magazines, and I thought, well, I'll do a composite of what I like about various characters and designing my new character. And so I did. The beard came from some Vincent Price movie. I don't remember which one. Parting the hair in the middle, quite frankly, I stole from the guy in New York, John Zacherle, that did that, you see. And other bits and pieces, you know, the spats I thought looked cool, you know, and the frock coat did, and so I put this all together and tried to make up out, you know. And actually, I went to the beauty shop and got to give me some hair that pretty well matched mine off the floor, and I snipped it up and made my own beard to start with, but it wouldn't let me grow one then, you see. And then the next step after the character caught on a little bit, the early pictures, it looks really pathetic, you know. I mean, this is Stone Age beard. But then I ran across one of these Hollywood types where you can glue it on, and it's mounted on silk organza and the stuff becomes invisible and you can't even really tell. In fact, the picture I used up until just a couple of years ago was me with a fake beard. It looks like it's growing right out of the face, you know. So, anyway, I put all this stuff together and tried it out. Thought there was something missing, and almost as an afterthought, I added a scar. And figured I would never really explain the scar. I just kind of liked it, you see. And that seemed to make it click. And it's been a tremendous amount of interest in the scar. And I've always kind of laughed inwardly about it, you know. As a character continues to develop, a number of years ago, I developed two answers, and people would say, "Where'd you get the scar?" It was a little kid, I'd say I bought it and used scar a lot.
I remember that.
If it was an adult, I'd say I got in the war and try to prompt them into saying, well, which war or what war? And I'd say the Boud War. but it worked. And we started getting an audience through the magic of television. Dr. Paul Bearer killed off Count Chocula and survived on the show. The TV station bought all the costume, which was used, I bought it from a used rental house, and except the shoes. They wouldn't buy shoes for it. I said, "What do you need shoes for?" I said, "We'll just shoot you from, you know, we'll never shoot your feet."
Right.
I said, "Bull," because I had in my mind to do personal appearances eventually, so I knew I had to have shoes. So I bought the shoes and the spats and those socks myself. The only part of the original costume that's still left is the tie and the shoes, which are over 25 years old, both of them. And the coat finally rotted away. I had it patched as much as I could. I had two shirts that were the button up the back formal shirts that you put a wingtip collar on, you know. And they finally rotted away. And I talked to one of them, hand making me two of them, you see. And so, you know, but it's been nip and tuck to hold the, you know, the costume together. The show started to work in North Carolina, came up with good ratings, and I moved to Florida. It was off the air for about, I was on the air about 6.5 years in North Carolina. Even after I left the TV station, I freelanced the show back to them, you see, which worked. When I moved to Florida, I brought the props with me. Some of my props are the original props going back 25 years at all. Dust off every once in a while and put out there, you know, and hope they don't look at them too closely.
Welcome back. The clip you just watched only exists because I didn't have a tape recorder to do the interview and at the last minute decided to film it. The film from this became the transcript for the lost interview of Dr. Paul Bearer, which still stands today as the lengthiest interview ever conducted about the character. Over the course of that afternoon, Dick Binnick and I talked about a lot of different things concerning the character, including some of the traits that endeared him to so many fans over the years. One of his best-loved bits was his product spoofs, of everything from breakfast cereal to laundry detergent. So let's take a look now at some of those products he spoofed over the years.
Well, good afternoon, whatever you are, and welcome to the tenement castle of Dr. Paul Bearer. I was just sitting here reading the latest issue of Newsweek magazine. Yeah, with all the trouble over in the Mideast over there, I think, reading an interesting article here on how we can solve all these problems. What we do is we send a contingent over there made up of Dracula and the Wolfman and the Mummy and Frankenstein and the Hunchback. And the werewolf, that'll quiet them down. There won't be a war then, because we'll scare the pants off of them. And who ever heard of fighting a war in your BVDs? I guess really I ought to get involved in all this and maybe join the radioactive reserves. Well, I have written a song. A little later on, we'll go out in the music room and hear it. It's about World War III, and I figure if we're going to write a song about that war, we better write it right now. And it's one of my latest decompositions. But right now, let's watch a horrible old movie for this afternoon, which happens to be The Brain That Wouldn't Die. And it's really horrible. My name isn't Dr. Paul Bearer. Well, Fright fans, we certainly hope you're enjoying our horrible old movie. I was enjoying the latest issue of Better Tombs and Gardens. Siri, particularly enjoyed an article in here where it says you can add a lot of life to your place if you take in a houseplant. Well, I decided for my houseplant, I would take in a weeping willow tree, and here it is. Oh, come on now, calm down. That's enough weeping. Well, you take it easy. All right, just settle down. Come on. Right, easy does it now. That's a good fella. Now, wait a minute. I got to fix you up here. All right, now blow. Okay, yeah, that's pretty good. All right, now that we got our weeping willow tree calmed down, we can go back and watch our horrible old movie. Oh, not again. Well, you take it easy. Come on, calm down. Will you hold it? Just calm down a little bit, all right? Easy, dog. That's a good fella. Yeah, all right. Yeah. Well, Fright fans, we hope you enjoyed our first horrible old movie, which was Planet on the Prowl. And all that prowling around gave me a bit of a thirst, so I thought I might enjoy mixing up a little bit of shrink lemonade. Yeah, Siri, let me try that. Say, that's pretty tasty. That shrink lemonade's not bad at all. On the other hand, I'm beginning to feel a little strange. Son of a gun. What is happening here? I'm shrinking. My goodness. Boy, when they said shrink lemonade, they meant it, didn't they? Wow, what am I going to do now? In a predicament I'm in right now? Well, I'll tell you, while I figure out how to get out of this, why don't you go ahead and watch some more of a horrible old movie. Well, Fright fans, I hope you're enjoying The Mummy. I think you'll admit this guy has a face that only a mummy could love. Well, I picked up a copy of a magazine that all the girls seem to be buying. I thought I'd look into it. It's called Play Ghoul magazine. And of course, like all the ghouls do, I want to turn to the centerfold and see what's so interesting in there. And they got an extra large centerfold this month. Ah, there we go. We'll tear it out and see what it is all about. What makes that magazine so interesting to all the ghouls? Wow, that's a big one. Okay, ah, here we go. About to open it. Well, no wonder. So that's what they're all interested in. There you go, the centerfold in this month's Play Ghoul magazine. And I think all the girls would admit that that guy is really built. Well, let's come back and watch some more of The Mummy while I read some more of Play Ghoul magazine. Well, Fright fans, I hope you enjoyed our horrible old movie for today. And as Karis said to the mummy, that about wraps it up. Well, since I have to work the graveyard shift tonight, I guess I better get a little shut-eye in between now and then. You know, I don't really like to work at an undertaking parlor, but where else can I go and find my job all laid out for me? Well, don't forget, good night, and don't let the bed bugs... Speaking of bed bugs, by the way, I don't really sleep alone. I got a few of these critters in here, and I think I got a little too many around now, so fortunately, I happen to keep a trusty can of frayed around. So now that I have it, I can get rid of these little suckers, and here we go.
Frayed!
That ought to take care of it. And now I can simply say, don't forget, next Saturday afternoon, I'll be lurking for you. Well, good afternoon, whatever you are, and welcome to the tenement castle of Dr. Paul Vera. Sorry to be a little late. We've had a real busy week and a strange one, too. Like first part of the week where he cremated a drunk. His liver burned for 3 days. As a matter of fact, we had to get a liquor license to bury the ashes. I spent so busy, I stopped by and got some of that fast food to bring home. Yes, sir, let me get it out here and I'll tell you all about it. I stopped by that place known as the Red Blobster. And happen to get some of their stuff. It looks pretty good, and it's blobbing all around there, too. Well, that kind of brings us to our movie. Nothing better than eating a snack and watching a horrible old movie. And today we have The Mask of the Red Death. And it's really horrible. Well, my name isn't Dr. Paul Vera. Well, I hope you're enjoying our horrible old movie. I was trying to get the hearse all cleaned up for public appearances that I'll probably be making in your area soon. And of course, I like to use Fangtastic to clean up the hearse with. You know, it's a pretty good old hearse. I bought it used. It's only used once, as a matter of fact, by a suicide victim. And the only thing wrong with it were the lipstick stains on the exhaust pipe. On the other hand, she might have been trying to blow up the hearse. Who knows? Well, anyway, while I try to get the lipstick stains off the exhaust pipe, why don't you watch some more of our horrible old movie? Well, Fright fans, we certainly hope you're enjoying our horrible old movie. I don't know about you, but quite frankly, I work up quite an appetite watching these horrible old things. So I thought today I might try that new cereal I've been hearing a lot about. It's put out by the Kellogg's Company, and it's called Ghost. Siri. And let me see if I can get the box and go make myself a bowl of Ghost cereal. Well, I'll just try that one again. Son of a gun. Of course, that's one of the problems with trying to eat Ghost cereal is getting it. Well, maybe I can sneak up on it a little bit.
Oh, son of a gun. Well, I'm determined to have some ghost cereal. There it went. Well, while I try to snag the ghost cereal and make myself a bowl, why don't you watch some more of our horrible old movie? Okay?
When Dr. Paul Bearer wasn't busy flogging phony products on his show, he often welcomed a pretty kooky cast of characters into the tenement castle. Whether this was an old chum from college, some bizarre passers-by, or maybe even his own dear old mummy, you always knew you were in for a treat when that doorbell rang.
Well, Fright fans, we certainly hope you're enjoying our horrible old movie for today. You know, I've been expecting my old school chum, Jack the Ripper, to come by today. Hey, maybe that's him now. Anyway, let me see who's at the door. Well, I can't seem to get the door to open. Oh, there it is. I'll get this thing fixed one of these days. Well, son of a gun. Jack, good to see you.
Good to see you.
Been a long time, yes sir.
You'll never forget our old school days together.
Oh, yes.
We were a couple of cut-ups, weren't
we? Oh, yeah. I wish I'd said that. Well, Jack, you know, in spite of all the good times we had at cutting you, our old pre-med school.
Never forget it.
There's one thing I always wanted to know.
Well, we're old school chums. You can ask me anything, my
good
man.
I was always curious why they called you Jack the Ripper.
Why do they call me Jack the Ripper?
Yeah, that's
it. You want to know
why
they call me Jack the Ripper?
Yeah, why do they call you Jack?
Why?
Well, I mean, you don't have to get all upset.
Do they call me Jack the Ripper?
Yeah, that's
the
question.
That's
a simple question.
Why do they call me Jack the Ripper?
That's it.
Why do they call me Jack the Ripper?
Yeah, that's it.
Why do they call me Jack the Ripper?
Well, we didn't upset him that much. Gee, now we'll probably never know why they called him Jack the Ripper. Oh, well, let's go back and watch some more of our horrible old movie. Well, Fright fans, I'm sorry to be a little late getting back.
Well, Doc, where in the world have you been? I was getting a little worried about you.
Well, Benjamin, I stopped by the pet store and I got us a new pet.
Boy, I'll say, when you buy a pet, you really buy a pet. Hey, keep that thing away from me.
Well, Benjamin, I'm kind of surprised at you. I thought this was the kind of pet you'd probably go ape over.
Yeah, I know. Oh, very funny, very funny. Now, what in the world are you going to feed him?
What am I going to feed him? Anything he wants. Well, I don't care whether you like him or not. I think he's the kind of pet that I can really get a kick out of. Oh, not that cut. Will you cut that out? And maybe you'll get a kick out of our movie. This is really horrible. My name isn't Dr. Paul Vera. Now behave yourself. What's the matter with you? Settle down. Will you cut that out? Really? Oh, boy. Well, good afternoon, whatever you are, and welcome to the tenement castle of Dr. Paul Bearer. This being the Saturday before Mummy's Day being tomorrow, my mummy is supposed to come by and visit me this afternoon. That must be her now. Oh, I haven't seen her in a long time, I'll tell you that. Well, come in, Mummy. Well, it's good to see you. By golly, you're wrapped real well today. Sorry I didn't meet you at the airport like I promised to. Well, I couldn't help it. I had to work overtime at the funeral parlor. If you're going to act like that, I'm sorry you even came. Well, let's go watch our movie while I try to calm her down. Now, really, I meant to meet you at the airport. Watch it out there. Well, Fright fans, we certainly hope you're enjoying our horrible old movie for today. Yeah, there's one thing we try to do here on Fright... Son of a gun. That's one thing we try to do here on Creature Feature, and that is, of course, bring you the most horrible... Don't worry about him. He's just our fly-by-night, which goes to show you what a fly-by-night show this is. So So why don't we get back and watch some more of our horrible old movie? Quite frankly, I've been involved in a hobby here. As you can see, I've started a small monster collection. It's a very small monster, as a matter of fact. I think I'll name him Calvin. That sounds like a pretty good name. Yeah. Well, I'll tell you, you might wonder why I want to have a small monster collection. Well, most people collect stamps, but then anybody can lick a stamp. How many people can lick a monster? Well, that's the first one in my small monster collection. Well, Fright fans, we certainly hope you're enjoying our horrible old movie. Nothing beats sitting around the house on a Saturday afternoon watching a horrible old movie. Sound like someone's at the door. Let me see who it is. Well, come on in, whoever you are. Siri, we have a couple of guests in the tenement castle. Siri, come on in. And obviously, I think you've spotted that we have visiting us today the Moss brothers. And let's see, one of them is Pedro. That's Pedro, and the other one's Jose. Spanish Moss brothers, you might say. And I bet you fellas came here to collect the bill, huh? You want the bill from Christmas. I was afraid of that. Well, hang on a second. I got it here in the coffin table. Get it out for you. Yes, sir, you came to get the bill, and here's the bill for you to collect. Came from one of my favorite birds. Sir, actually, I'll have to admit that the Moss brothers, you don't like that, huh? Okay, sorry about that. The Moss brothers costumes were designed by Ricky Gurdon of San Antonio, Florida, and we spotted them, I think it was at Countryside Mall around Halloween. We asked them to visit our show, and we were happy to have the Moss brothers here with us. Always wanted to meet those guys. Yeah, I'm telling you, I had a hunch that you were going to be good-looking, but once I've seen them, I think I'd rather have my hunch back. Now, let's go back and watch some more of our horrible old movie.
Sadly, WTOG did not archive the Creature Feature program. In the early days, videotape was very expensive, and so very few fans could afford to record it. Most of the material that exists today is from the later era of the show. Some of the early material does exist, though, because Dick Bennett recorded some of the more elaborate bits. These were ones that he preferred to save to use in the future, rather than having to recreate them. So let's take a look now at some of those elaborate pieces that Dick saved, including one very politically incorrect song that became one of his most requested bits.
Oh, good afternoon. And welcome to Out Behind the Tenement Castle of Dr. Paul Bearer. I was just checking the embalming fluid in my hearse, and it looks like I have plenty. You know, this is getting to be the time of year when a lot of folks are inviting me into their towns for personal appearances, and I thought perhaps I'd better make sure the hearse is all ready to go. Our never-ready battery is charged like usual, and I was kind of working some of the bugs out of the engine to make sure that we'll be able to get to wherever you are and meet all the Fright fans. It's unbelievable how many bugs you can get in a hearse over a period of time, but they're gradually working out where we ought to be able to make it and get back all right. Normally I feature one-way trips when I go on the hearse, but I like to make a round trip myself. Well, anyway, while I'm working the bugs out of the engine, why don't you go ahead and watch our first horrible old feature this afternoon? It's really horrible, for my name isn't Dr. Paul Bearer. Well, hello, Fright fans, and welcome to the Tenement Castle of Dr. Paul Bearer. Did you ever have one of those days where if your head hadn't been screwed on, you'd have forgotten it? Well, I just did, and we've been trying to get back together ever since. Come on, over this way. Hey, over this way, stupid. Here I am. Here I am. Okay, now lock on. There we go. You got me? Okay. All righty. Put me down. May I join you? Well, while we try to get our act together, why don't you go ahead and watch our horrible old movie? And it's really horrible. Or my name isn't Dr. Paul Vera. Okay, I'm with you. Watch it easy. Well, Fright fans, I hope you're enjoying our horrible old movie. And I thought I'd take a moment here to go through the fan mail. We had one letter that came cascading in this week. Let's see. This is from Patty from Cincinnati, whom we met at the Sun and Fun Festival Parade in Clearwater. She said, I enjoyed meeting you at the Sun and Fun Festival Parade, and I just wanted to tell you that I think you have a beautiful body. Well, thank you very much, Patty, and I agree with you. I think I do have a beautiful body, and I keep it right over here. And now that you've seen my beautiful body, we can go back and watch some more of our horrible old movie. Well, Fright fans, hope you're enjoying our horrible old movie. Quite frankly, I was getting a little stiff sitting there. Thought I might feel better if I stood up and stretched my legs. Now that I've stretched my legs, I feel better. We can go on and watch some more of our horrible old movie. Well, Fright fans, I certainly hope you enjoyed our horrible old movie, and while you were watching the movie, quite frankly, I tried some of the shampoo I've been hearing a lot about, Headless Shoulders, and you can see that apparently it works because my shoulders are headless. Well, when I try to figure out what to do about this, I think I'll let you watch a little bit more of the movie. I don't frankly know if I'm gonna try this Headless Shoulder shampoo again or not. And right now, I want to warn you to get all the kids out of the room right now because we're going to do something that's never been done before on Creature Feature. We're going to have a topless go-go dancer on in just a few minutes. So I want to give you a chance to get all the kids out of the room. Siri, I'll tell you how this happened. I was out acting like a night crawler the other night, and I met a topless go-go dancer. And she impressed me so much that I asked her to stop by. Good to see you again. You're looking lovely. Partially. And we thought we'd try to loosen up some of the kinks from sitting in the old chair and dance to the Monster Mash.
I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight. For my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the Monster Mash. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom where the vampires feast, the ghouls all came from their humble abode to get a jolt from my electrode.
They did the mash.
They did the Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
They did the Monster Mash. Now everything's cool, Drax a part of the band, and my Monster Mash is the hit of the land. For you, the living, this mash was meant to. When you get to my door, tell them what it said.
Then you can mash.
Then you can Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
And you, my graveyard smash.
Then you can mash.
You'll catch on in a flash.
Then you can mash.
Then you can Monster Mash.
Well, that was a lot of fun, and I certainly hope you enjoyed watching our topless go-go dancer. And with that out of the way, let's get back and watch some more of our horrible old movie. Oh. Well, Fright fans, welcome to the tenement castle of Dr. Paul Bearer. We'll get on with our movie in just a moment, but just before you came in, I answered the door and we had an Avon sales lady to call on me. Now, what is it you're selling, my dear?
We're selling vanishing cream this month.
Vanishing cream? Let me see
that.
I don't believe in vanishing cream, really.
Excuse me, Dr. Paul Bear, but it is rather warm in here.
Warm? Well, make yourself comfortable.
Oh, thank you.
Vanishing cream. I can't believe that. You know, I had a fellow one time, I think they called him, I don't know what they called him before, but he... He was around selling some instant hair restorer, and he spilled some all over him. And by golly, before we could do anything about it, the next thing he knew, he was a werewolf smothered to death. Couldn't even find a pair of scissors. Vanishing cream. What in the world would I use vanishing cream for anyway? I don't know. I really can't see how I'd use it. I mean, my complexion is smooth enough as it is, and, Well, where in the world did she go? She must have realized she wasn't gone.
I'm right here. Well, be careful.
You're putting me on.
I tell you, it really works.
Yeah. Well, speaking of putting on, I think we better put the movie on right now. Well, Fright fans, we hope you're enjoying our horrible old movie. Quite frankly, I didn't care for it, so I thought I'd come up and sort of fool around in the music room a little bit. You know, I guess we get more mail sent to the Tenement Castle requesting one song, and quite frankly, it's my favorite. So if you don't mind, here goes once again with Poisoning Pigeons in the Park.
Spring is here, a suffering is here. Life is Skittles and life is beer. I think the loveliest time of the year is the spring. I do, don't you? Of course you do. But there's one thing that makes spring complete for me and makes every Sunday a treat for me. All the world seems in tune on a spring afternoon when we're poisoning pigeons in the park. Every Sunday you'll see my sweetheart and me as we poison the pigeons in the park. When they see us coming, the birdies all try and hide, but they still go for peanuts when coated with cyanide. The sun's shining bright, everything seems all right when we're poisoning pigeons in the park. La la. Notoriety and caused much anxiety in the Audubon Society with our games. They call it impiety and lack of propriety and quite a variety of unpleasant names. But it's not against any religion to want to dispose of a pigeon. So if someday you're free, why don't you come with me and we'll poison the pigeons in the park. Maybe we'll do in a squirrel or two while we're poisoning pigeons in the park. We'll murder them all amid laughter and merriment, except for the few we take home to experiment. My pulse will be quickening with each drop of strychnine we feed to a pigeon. It just takes a smidgen to poison a pigeon in the park.
Well, like they say, music hath charms to soothe. I gotta get some toothpaste. My teeth are loose. Music hath charms to soothe the savage beast. And it's always quite a joy to come up here and plunk away on my Frankenstein way piano. Well, while we piddle around the music room, why don't you watch some more of our horrible old movie?
Dick Benick passed away in February of 1995. He had just finished recording the final hosting segments for Creature Feature only a few months earlier and had every intention of returning to the character that he loved so much. The effect that Dr. Paul Bearer had on over three decades of kids is obvious in the number of fans that remain loyal to him and the show to this very day. It's hard not to smile when we remember one of the Doctor's bad puns, or to think that it's Saturday afternoon, and many years ago we would have been holed up in a dark room watching I Married a Monster from Outer Space while the good doctor ate Strangles potato chips and drank Choke soda. As long as there's a monster kid to remember him, the good doctor will always be up in that great tenement castle in the sky, lurking for us.
Well, we certainly hope you enjoyed our horrible old movie for today. Quite frankly, we won't apologize for it because it was all we could scare up. But anyway, right now it's time to split. Well, where are you going? Well, I thought I'd go out and take a walk. You want to come along? No, I think I'll just stay here and take a nap, you know.
Okay, I'll see you later.
Yeah, I'll see you later. All right, so long.
Yeah.
And we'll see you folks next time around, too.
I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight. For my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the
monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard.